We are on to import export platform Facebook Live, and we'll continue the conversation we started yesterday about Nigerian export past, present, and future. And we'll basically review the trade statistics. So this morning we'll continue from where we stopped. The export of Nigeria from 2014 till date. We've been having some increase, like I said yesterday, 2016 and 17 increase, and then 17 to 18 we have an increase, and that has been consistent for a while now. Our major export in 2018 goes to India, Spain, France, South Africa, Netherlands, and I'm reading for quarter four. The top, sorry, I'm trying to check the detail. Okay, now in quarter four of 2018, the major export destinations are Europe, Asia, America, and Africa. Europe 43%, Asia 20%, America 14%, Africa 13%. Now, when you look at import, Asia is 39%, Europe is 42%. And this is clearly saying that if you are looking for market for Nigerian product, our major import export, our major import origin, our major export destination are basically Europe. Adewale Amole, thank you very much for joining. Mary Helen, thank you very much for joining. Mickey Obaisi, thank you very much for joining. Adolphus Ali, good morning. Olale Kankazim, thank you very much for joining. Good morning, everyone, and welcome. We are discussing Nigerian export past, present, and future. I basically review some of the statistics released by the government, and then gaining some insight from those statistics so that anybody looking at going into export, you might be get to look at the product you should be focusing on, and more importantly, also the market you should be giving a kind consideration. The market should be given that kind of consideration. Now, if you look at the agri sector, the major export, like I said yesterday, were sesame seed, then cocoa, then cashew nut. Sesame seed, cocoa, and cashew nut. And the major export was going to, that's for agri export now, you have majorly going to the same area, Europe, Africa, America, Asia, and Oceania. But majority of our commodity is going to Asia. Majority of the commodity from Nigeria is going to Asia. Now, on the import side, majority of the agri product we are buying is actually from Europe. So we sell more of our agri commodity to Asia and buy more actually from European. For example, sesame seed export, major buyer in 2014 was China, and that is followed by Japan, and that is followed by India, and that is followed by Turkey. And lastly, Vietnam. By the way, a number of people that have exported to Vietnam have expressed concern and worry about the way Vietnamese have been dealing with Nigerians in terms of export in recent time. And basically, what has happened is that a number of them do not pay on time or do not pay at all. So if you are trying to ship product out of Nigeria, you are into commodity, I would strongly recommend you consider other countries and avoid Vietnam as much as possible, especially if you don't have a secure payment method. Looking at minerals, most of our minerals went to Asia. Most of the mineral went to Asia, and that's over 2 billion, and then some to Europe, followed by Europe, and then Africa. We do not have any shipment to America and Oceania, so obviously we don't have buyers for minerals from Nigeria, in America, and Oceania. So if you're thinking of exporting raw materials like minerals, you know, you can be looking at Oceania, you can be looking at America, you probably are looking at Asia, who are the major buyer, China leading the way, and then of course Europe, Africa, then Europe. And for Africa, since it's minerals, it's raw commodity, majorly goes to South Africa. In terms of import, majority of our minerals import also come from Asia. This time around, value added mineral from Asia, then followed by Europe, then followed by Africa, and lastly from the America. Understandably so, majority of our manufactured product from Nigeria will go to our neighbor. Majority goes to our neighbor. That's about 38 billion, actually. 38 billion naira goes to our neighbor. Our neighbor, I mean, by neighbor, I mean Africans. Africans. Then Asia before even Europe. And you know, Europe is very skeptical about our product. You know, since most of the African countries are not into manufacturing like a lot of European nations, and we are having the African Continental Free Trade Agreement that about 52 countries have signed, Nigeria and two other countries are yet to sign, but majority of Africa have signed already, so they are leaving us behind. But we are hoping that the president will sign now that the election is over. Nobody will be politicizing the game, probably be able to get the president to sign. But what I'm trying to say is that the major product we will be leveraging on in that space as a nation will be manufactured goods. Most of our manufactured goods go to Africa. And now it can go to Africa duty-free, so it can be more competitive than what they are probably buying from Asia or probably buying from Europe, because now we're going to be exporting to them duty-free. And that's the whole idea of African Continental Free Trade Agreement. How do we have over 1 billion population in Africa, but foreigners are the ones enjoying the market? And that's why the African government came together to do the African Continental Free Trade Agreement. And majority of the countries on the continent have signed, even though most of them have not ratified. Okay, Abubakar Kolere, China also suing Nigeria, either reducing the quality deliberately to shortage, shortchange you, or outrightly refuse to pay. We do not have efficient institution in Nigeria. You're right. You're very right. Which is why, in our recommendation for export market entry, you need to have a rep at destination. One of the ways to significantly reduce the risk of not getting paid in China or in any market, really, in any market, is, and what Abubakar have just talked about also happened in Europe, actually. Only that it's not very common in Europe as much as it's in Asia. But one of the ways, if you're going into export market, one of the ways to reduce the risk of export market entry, one of the major ways of reducing that risk, is by basically getting a rep at destination. Having a rep, a presence at destination, by virtue of a rep, an agent or distributor, a partner, or your own company that you register. But the fact is that you must have a rep at destination to be able to ensure that that business will be sustained. Else, you might be dealing with some unscrupulous element who will just want to take advantage of you because you are far away and you are not close by. And of course, they're taking advantage of the fact that you are not going to be able to easily come around and fight them, or to be able to get whatever it is they are taking away from you. So I agree with you 100%. I was just referencing Vietnam because of the recent issues Nigerians are having in Vietnam. But the issue of not getting paid is not just only Vietnam. Some Chinese companies also have done that in the past. I've had experience in the past where we ship goods. They pay the initial payment and the final payment. They're saying we have to do the next shipment before they will pay. You know, I mean, it's just amazing the way some buyers behave. But like I said, having a rep at destination makes it a lot easier to fight that out. Omavore, I hope I didn't mutilate your name. Favor, sorry if I didn't pronounce the name very well. Thank you very much for joining. Good morning, Shayo Peter Akimbo Wali. Thank you very much for joining. Good morning and welcome. All right, so we're basically analyzing the exportation from Nigeria in the year 2018, and then using that to project into the future for people to have an idea of what they should be looking at in terms of export. And as I said yesterday, for those of you that probably did not hear me yesterday or listen to me yesterday, the major export we still ship out of Nigeria is still oil. Even though non-oil component is growing, it went as high as 6.2 in 2018. It was 4.6 in 2016, and it was much more lower than that in 2015. So we can see some progression in that direction. And I posted something on Facebook that a lot of people liked because, I mean, those are fans of the current administration are eager to share because of the fact that the government they put in place is performing. And my opinion is, irrespective of what anybody think about whatever government is in place, I'm just interested in performance. Have they been able to perform? Is there anything they are doing that is commendable? Is there anything else they are doing that is not right? So we can also criticize it for them to be able to make a change. What should happen at the end of the day? Nigeria should be the one to win. So at the end of the day, we can leave more people out of poverty in this country. Like I said yesterday, that the data available reveal that we really are not out of the woods yet. By out of the woods, I mean we are not there yet in terms of non-oil export. We can still do a lot more than we're currently doing. But the what has happened so far is that the effort being made by the administration seems to be yielding results, especially on the non-oil export, which for me is very critical, because what the use of you saying you are exporting and all that you export is one commodity, such that if the day there is an issue with that commodity, then you just realize you are not in business at all and that you are just an endangered fish. And that was exactly what we faced during the recession. As a nation. And I think that, look, we can't really continue that way. There must be change. And we've seen some changes. And I'm hoping that those changes that we've seen will be sustained. If you look at the data for Nigerian exports in 2017, total export in the world, rather, was 28.9 billion. Total import into Nigeria was 28.9 billion. And our major imports were minerals, fuel, machineries, electrical equipment, vehicles, cereals, plastics, sulfur, salt and stone and cement, fish, article of iron and steel, and other chemicals. Those are the major import items in 2017. And if you continue that in 2018, we are still operating within the same band. And where are we importing from? Basically from China, United States, Germany, Japan, Netherlands, Korea, Hong Kong, France, Italy. Now, if you look at the, what was of interest to me now is the export we are doing. Now, our top export destination. Let me talk about our top export item first. I'm looking at 2017 now, and I'll compare 2018. Top export destination was, top export product were fuel, that's crude oil, mineral fuel, ships and boats, cocoa, oil seed, fertilizer, tobacco, plastic, fruit and nuts, hide and skin, raw hide and leather, then rubber. These are the major items we exported in the year 2017. But let's compare that with year 2018. The major item of export in the year 2018. I'm trying to get that. Major export item, as usual, mineral fuel took a good chunk of it. Contributing about 84%, and natural oil and natural gas and liquefied gas 9.91%. So I like to put that together because they're both oil and gas. So we basically have about 94%, in terms of exports being done out of Nigeria, about 94%. Sorry, I'm trying to compare the, okay. Now, 2017, it was 96%. Sorry, I'm trying to just. Someone is asking a question. Is there anybody like Commodity Forum that can champion the challenge of exporter as major front with any country in and with any country in Nigeria government? The only body right now that should take up that I know is the Nigerian Export Promotion Council. So I think if you have a challenge, Nigerian Export Promotion Council might be able to advise. I know there is a cargo defense fund with Nigerian Shippers Council that you can access to be able to support with financing in case they need, there's a litigation that needs to be done around product you have exported. So you might need to check with Nigerian Promotion Council and Nigerian Shipper Council. Nigerian Promotion Council and the Nigerian Shipper Council. So what are the major exports of Nigeria in 2018? Now, non-oil now. We still have cocoa, sesame seed, cashew nuts, frozen shrimps, coconut, flowers, agro food, fruits, flour mills, and spices. Now, top on the list. Now, you notice something about all that we ship. They are mainly agric products. That's the challenge I'm having. 2017, we're still able to do some value-added products like manufactured goods or product like ship and boat, like fertilizer, like tobacco. That was in 2017. So there was some level of value addition, But in 2018, even though we have more non-oil 2018, but we did more of commodities. Now, the challenge with commodity is that a nation concentrating on commodity will not be able to make any significant progress. A nation concerned on commodity will not be able to make any significant progress. And the reason is very simple. When you do commodities, you basically are helping the country where you are buying from. So the people that enjoy the benefit of all your labor are the foreigners. The people that enjoy the benefit of your labor are the foreigners, who are buying the raw material and adding value. And I was talking about the fact that there was a time I bought a sesame seed biscuit from the UK, and I checked the body of that sesame seed biscuit. Guess what I saw on it? Made in Poland. And I know sesame seed is purchased from Nigeria by Poland, by the Polish people. So they added value. So at the end of the day, nobody even knows if Nigeria produced sesame seed, but they know that Poland produced, manufacture sesame seed biscuits. Sesame seed biscuits, even though the raw material is from here. And that's the challenge of raw materials. And when you also focus on raw material like we do, you don't have enough market around the world. It restricts where you can sell that product to. When you focus on commodity, you restrict yourself as to kind of market you can access when you focus on commodity. But when you focus on finished product, it becomes a lot easier for you to grow and expand. Because at the end of the day, you have market in different other places in the world, market in different other countries in the world, rather than just focusing on commodities. But what are we seeing? We've seen more of commodities being done in Nigeria, more of commodities. So 2018, in my opinion, even though our agri was more, but I'm still not very impressed. So our non-oil export was more than 4.6, 6.2 in 2018 and 4.6 in 2017. But I'm still not impressed with the agri commodity. You know, if you check the volume of export from Africa every year, it's always growing in terms of metric tons. But if you check that vis-a-vis the total value of exports in the world, it's so small. In 2017, we did 2.6%. 2.6%. Because we are basically exporting raw materials and crude. And so at the end of the day, the people that enjoy the benefit, the people that are making the money, are the value. Let me show you a statistics. Let me show you statistics. Look at these statistics. In 2014, total merchandise export in Nigeria. In 2014, total merchandise export in Nigeria, sorry, total merchandise export in the world was $18.5 trillion. 2014, total merchandise export in Nigeria in the world was $18.5 trillion. Total service export was about $5 trillion. Now, out of the $18.5 trillion for merchandise export, $12.25 trillion were for manufactured goods. $1.7 trillion was for agric. $1.7 trillion was for agric. Who is making money? Who is making money? The manufacturer person or the agric person? If we focus on agric, we are going nowhere. If we focus on agric, we are going nowhere. We are going to just be depending still on the West, who are creating a lot of job for their people and buy only commodity from us. But we have the population in Africa, so we should produce for Africa and Africans. If the West are not going to buy from us because it's manufactured good and they have concern about where we are producing, you know, there are so many non-tariff barriers in terms of regulation, documentation, you know, all, they are all non-tariff barriers. They are just strategy to ensure. They know we have challenge in Africa and they are doing everything to ensure that we do not match up. In fact, sometimes they will even advise us not to subsidize our farmers. And with different economic theory to defend it, whereas they are doing it themselves. Come to think of it now, we talk, say Africa is corrupt, but the people that are stealing the money in Africa are keeping it in banks in Europe. But Africa is corrupt, but the money is kept in a bank in Europe. And there is an adage in Yoruba land that says that both the person that stole the stuff on top of the roof and the person that collected it down, the two of them are thieves. Both the person that stole and then that collected it. So I don't let us be fooled and thinking these people love us. They give us aid primarily to have control over us. They give us aid. Anytime they give us an aid, there's a reason for it. Any law they made in your favor, there's a reason for it. They want to use it to control us. So let's focus on Africa. There's so much that can be done only on the African continent if only we live up to expectation. So Nigeria should be more interested in the value addition to be sold within the West African sub-region. And if you're listening to me, you have product that is already packaged for export, good quality product, and you're looking for market abroad, then you want to join the Lagos Chamber of Commerce together with Nigeria's Exportation Council and NACIMA at the forthcoming Made in Nigeria exhibition, solo exhibition in Cote d'Ivoire, in which every Nigerian will be converging at the Cultural Palace in Abidjan to be able to get this just to promote export within West Africa. Just to promote export within West Africa. Who are the top exporters in Africa? In 2017, we are here with 2018 data. 2017, top exporter was South Africa. South Africa contributed 19.5%. Guinea was second, 13.7, and Nigeria was third, 9.8. Nigeria was third, 9.8. So total exports out of Nigeria. We're looking at total export now out of Nigeria to other part of the world. And Nigeria was third, 9.8. So the question we should ask ourselves is, why is Nigeria third? I thought we're supposed to be giant of Africa. But you and I know that we really have not lived up to that expectation, because in a lot of ways, people like South Africa are leading the way for Nigeria to follow, at least in this area. And the total export of Africa was $452 billion. Do you know that the export of UK alone is more than the whole of Africa put together? UK export is over $400 billion. Nigeria export of is around 400 billion. People go to UK is about 60, 70 million people. Africa is over 1 billion people. But Africa is exporting more, less than what the whole of UK, sorry, UK is exporting more than what the whole of Africa is doing. Not because Africa is not exporting, but what Africa is exporting are commodities, and the price is very low. Let me give you an instance. I often use cashew nut, for example. A ton of cashew nut, raw cashew nut, is about $1,000, $1,500. A ton of cashew kernel is about $10,000 to $15,000. So when you now look at the volume of what was exported in terms of metric ton, Nigeria is leading the way. But when you look at the value of what was exported, and when they are going to quantify, they're going to use the value of what was exported. When you look at the value of what was exported, you're going to look at it in terms of the, that's what they're going to use to judge. And that's what they use to know the volume of who is really doing what. Not the quantity, but the quality in terms of the value of what has been exported. So even though Nigeria is doing a lot in volume, but in value delivered to Nigeria, sorry, even though Africa is doing a lot in volume, but in terms of value delivered in terms of payment to Africa is very low, just about 450 billion. That's so small. Let's look at, I'm trying to check top exporters in the world that same year. Top exporters in the world that same year. Yes, United Kingdom did 443. The whole of Africa did about 450. United Kingdom alone did 443 in terms of export volume. The whole of Africa did about 450. So what UK alone is doing is more than what the whole of Africa is doing, basically because of our focus on commodity. So very important, we begin to look at value-added products. And there's no reason to give excuse on this. Foreigners are coming here and they're able to do the same thing. What is the success strategy of foreign company exporting out of Nigeria like Olam? How can we replicate the strategy? They know what we don't know. The reason why foreigners come in from a place where there's no light, no water, no road, and come into a place where they come from a place where there's water, there's light, there's road, into a place where there's no water, no light, no road, and they're able to do more than us and better than us, mainly because they know what we don't know. And that's why we actually partner with a company in America, American Institute of Extended Studies, to start the American Institute of Extended Studies Diploma Program in Nigeria. So today we have the Diploma in Export Business Management and Diploma in Export Trade Finance. Every Saturday we meet. And at the end of 6 months, the people write a major exam to be able to get certified. But more importantly, they would have learned enough to be able to make the business success. So I think the major gap, the difference between us, is just the knowledge gap. Knowledge gap between us and the foreigner that are coming in and being able to export successfully out of Nigeria. Thank you very much for listening again. My name is Dele Ayemiba, and this is Import Export Platform. See you in the evening by 8 p.m. as we continue our conversation on Nigerian export, past, present, and future, part 3. Bye for now.